Do you ever feel like you're a bit of a hobbit yourself? Always wanting a second breakfast and cherishing quiet moments? Well, in the heart of Indonesia lies a tale as intriguing as any mythical story by J R R Tolkien. The discovery of Homo Floresiensis, also known as the Hobbit people. This video will take you on a journey to uncover the secrets of the species that redefines our understanding of human evolution. Stay with us to explore the astonishing life of these miniature humans and why their existence on a remote island challenged what we thought we knew about our ancient ancestors. It was just another day of digging in Liangbao Cave, located in the island of Flores, for the archaeological team from Australia and Indonesia. Professor Mike Indiana Morwood was sweating it out in the tropical heat, dreaming of a cold beer at a local tavern. But instead of finding last night's leftovers, Mike's shovel struck something that would make him the envy of treasure hunters worldwide. Bones. But not just any bones. These were the petrified remains of an entirely new human species. Small in form, yet towering in their impact on our understanding of evolution. Dubbed Homo Floresiensis, the Hobbit people had been hiding out in plain sight for nearly 100,000 years. When the first skeletons of Homo Floresiensis were unearthed in Liangbao Cave, scientists were stunned by their diminutive proportions. Standing at just over 3 feet tall and weighing no more than 66 pounds, these hobbit-like humans were truly miniature compared to our other members of the Homo genus. Further analysis of multiple fossils revealed that the average Floresiensis adult stood approximately 1 meter tall and had body masses ranging from 25 to 60 pounds. Despite their short stature, detailed examinations of the skeletal remains has revealed a mosaic of both primitive and more modern anatomical traits. This has sparked a controversial debate among experts. Do these characteristics suggest a divergence from the Homo genus, or do they represent an unexpected branch of our own evolutionary tree? Cranially, Floresiensis possessed a long and low brain case, similar to early hominids, like Homo habilis. However, the average endocranial volume was only around 380 to 430 cc, which is comparable to chimpanzees and far smaller than any other known human species. This minuscule brain size, along with other craniofacial features such as projecting brows and facial morphology, suggests that Homo floresiensis retained more ancestral traits evolutionarily. At the same time, aspects of their postcranial skeleton, like relatively flexed knee and hip joints, indicate bipedal locomotion and tool use akin to Homo erectus and modern humans. This eclectic mix of primitive and advanced bodily features has challenged scientists to understand H. floresiensis' exact place on the human family tree. Some propose they evolved from an early Homo erectus population, while others argue from descent from an even older hominin lineage like Homo habilis. Either way, this species appears to have driven their body size reduction through insular dwarfism through many generations. Though small, Homo floresiensis has a complex evolutionary story reflected in its one-of-a-kind physical form. The size of their brain relative to their body, in particular, opens up a whole new realm of questions about what we thought we knew of human evolution. And if you are interested in learning more about the puzzling history of our species, make sure to follow for more. Despite its small brain size, the hobbit-sized hominid displayed advanced cognitive abilities, challenging controversial ideas about human evolution. The deep limestone deposits of Liangbao Cave have preserved the wealth of fossils and artifacts, shedding light on floresiensis' behavior and lifestyle. Analysis of brain surface features indicates enlarged temporal and frontal lobes, implying capabilities of speech, hearing, and higher cognition, potentially enabling the creation of sophisticated stone tools, thus providing insights into hobbit tool making, like stone cores and hammer stones, which indicate a basic chopping and cutting technology, also seen on some refined bone and bamboo artifacts that have been recovered from the site. Furthermore, animal bones excavated from cave sediments reveal butchery marks consistent with stone tools used for hunting and carcass processing. Though primitive, Homo floresiensis' tools and activities demonstrated their ability to survive and thrive on Flores despite their small physique. Intriguingly, archaeologists have also discovered hobbit skeletons carefully buried in shallow graves at the cave, suggesting some form of ritual behavior. The diverse artifacts and activity areas in Liangbao paint a picture of hobbits using this site as a long-term residential base. continued research at this crucial archaeological location promises to unveil new secrets about these enigmatic early humans. Now let's travel to a couple years back, about 100,000 to be a bit exact, a time when the lush tropical forests and grasslands of Flores provided an abundant home for Homo floresiensis. Towering trees offered fruits like figs and berries, which likely made up a large part of their diet, easily accessible for the hobbits without the need for ladders. But don't let their small size fool you. Homo floresiensis exhibited impressive adaptability and problem-solving skills to thrive in their island environment. They skillfully hunted to supplement their plant foods. The butchered animal bones found in their campsites revealed that this species was skilled at taking down larger prey that shared their island world, like pygmy stegodons and giant rat species, through teamwork and use of primitive stone tools. To better understand hobbit diet and hunting capabilities, researchers have studied these giant extinct rat species, dubbed giant bandicoots. By analyzing the rats' isotopic signatures and comparing them to hobbit fossils, scientists found evidence that the hobbits actively hunted and consumed these rodents. While the landscape has changed dramatically over tens of thousands of years, the lush rainforests and open grasslands would have provided bountiful foraging and hunting for these hominins. But determining the precise time frame in which Homo floresiensis inhabited the island of Flores has long puzzled the archaeological community. As we stated before, the earliest fossils date back around 100,000 years, indicating that hobbits emerged on the island quite early. They may have flourished relatively undisturbed for tens of thousands of years before other human species ever set foot on Flores. Even more astounding, recent radiometric dating of hobbit and human artifacts suggests a period of overlap between Homo floresiensis and Homo sapiens on the island around 50,000 years ago, a time frame much later than previously thought. If true, this indicates that hobbits coexisted with modern humans for some time rather than going extinct earlier, as some believe. This revelation begs the question, did our ancestors play a role in the disappearance of the species? Well, during this period of coexistence, Homo floresiensis and Homo sapiens may have interacted or even competed for resources. However, the nature and the extent of their interactions remain unclear. While disease, hunting, or habitat displacement by humans are candidate extinction theories, the hobbits may have simply evolved in isolation on Flores from a Homo erectus ancestor and were not a diseased modern human population as once proposed. Further isotopic analysis of hominin remains may help clarify whether the two species occupy different ecological niches or came into direct contact on the island. Scholars have long debated what led to the mysterious demise of our island-dwelling hobbit ancestors. Volcanic eruptions were initially suspected as a likely culprit, with some pointing to a massive eruption around 12,000 years ago that could have devastated Flores. However, recent dating of hobbit fossils indicates they survived much later, around 50,000 years ago. This rules out the eruption as a direct cause of their extinction. Climate change from shifting rain patterns or temperatures may have gradually altered the island ecosystem over centuries, stressing the hobbit population. Meanwhile, competition from arriving Homo sapiens around 45,000 years ago could have put further pressure on dwindling resources. Humans may have outcompeted the island hobbits for food and territory. Disease transmission is another possibility, as Homo floresiensis's isolated evolution left them vulnerable to pathogens carried by the new human immigrants, but endemic to them. But what if it wasn't over for these short-statured species? Some refuse to call it quits and believe them to still be around today, proposing that pockets of evolved Homo floresiensis may still be holding out in the island's misty mountains, places modern humans rarely tread. With dense forests to get lost in, perhaps small bands went into hiding and simply disappeared. Another theory suggests that, faced with catastrophe, the hobbits' tiny frames allowed them to transform before our eyes. Through rapid evolution on their remote island, they could have morphed into something nearly unrecognizable to their ancient ancestors. A new species may still wander the forests, concealed from science by shrewd survival instincts. While our hobbits shared the Homo name, they certainly didn't share the same stature. Homo sapiens, towering over these ancient ancestors at a whopping 5 feet tall, must have seemed like giants to the hobbit folk. While other human species, like Neanderthals, were built similarly robustly, Homo floresiensis took an opposite path. Their petite proportions suggest an extreme case of island dwarfism. Cut off from mainland giants, natural selection may have favored smaller frames better suited for the limited resources of Flores. Skeletally, it's clear that these hobbits evolved on their own curious branch, from their curved fingers to their sloping brows. Anatomy tells the tale of isolation's idiosyncratic impact on development. The exploration of Homo Floresiensis and the island realm continues to unfold, enriching our grasp of the human family tree with each discovery. What other puzzles does this evolutionary history have? Check out our next video, where we examine Homo Rudolfensis and why its classification has stirred debate among scientists.